Hello, Highland Dance World. I have a hardcore dance-filled weekend this weekend, so I'm going to bring you with me tonight. It is Friday night. I just had some dinner, and we are getting ready for a Shanachie performance, so I'm going to bring you behind the scenes, getting ready, all that good stuff. Tonight is our Burns Night Bash. We're doing this performance with the Fredericton St. Andrew Society Pipe Band, as well as Corsa. They're like a Celtic-y band, so it's always a sold-out show, always a really great night, so I'm going to take you behind the scenes, and then the rest of the weekend, also lots of dance things, so just a little peek into the life of, I guess, a dance studio owner, but also someone who's still actively performing, dancing, hanging out in the studio, so can't wait to bring you along for the ride. I'm not sure if this is the best filming angle, but honestly, I'm running late, so I just have to get this done. The one, don't judge me on how I do my makeup because I'm not a professional. The one product is gonna load. Classic influencer vibes. Okay, I go through this color. It's not cologne. I'm just gonna tell you. Bliss. Onto my full second tube. I have this down to the very end. Sometimes I honestly have to go for a darker one for dance performances because this one's not dark enough. I might do that actually. One that I use for shows is called Love. It's a little bit more red. I'm about to put eyeliner over top of eyeliner because time. Right now I'm running a few minutes late because I work too late, and I'm just manifesting that when I get to the parking lot, which is just so small compared to the size of the venue, that there is a parking spot for me right by the door because I have to bring in all the dance mats. So there's a Shanachie performance. You'll know it's a Shanachie performance by the amount of garbage bags filled with like those little mats that lock together. How many of those are in tow? Don't even have my hairspray, so this is gonna be. Gotta go find an elastic, pin it up, see you at the venue. Okay, the update is that I didn't manifest hard enough, and I'm parked pretty far away. Well, not super far away, but it's snowing and storming out. But anyway, I got a spot decently close, so taking you in for setup. Forgot that I was vlogging my day, and so I have to finish. So on the way, before I left for the performance, it was snowing, so the roads were really bad on the way there, and then it snowed the whole time we were dancing, but it stopped at around 10 snowing. So when I was driving home around 10, the roads weren't bad, and then I got home, it's now 10:35, and I'm stuck in the driveway. My car cannot make it. I'm off the road at least, but I am stuck halfway up
We have a very long driveway and I have a very small car. And now I have to wait for Cass to get his plow on the truck. He just got the car cleaned off, or truck cleaned off, 10:39 p.m. And now he has to get the plow on it, and then we gotta try and get my car not in the middle. I'll show you what's happening. Yeah. So that's a work in progress. My car gets stuck in the driveway usually maybe bi-monthly. So I'll keep you posted how long this takes us tomorrow morning. Okay, good news. We successfully made it out of the driveway last night. It honestly didn't take too long. Maybe like 10 minutes once the plow. It's just a matter of like getting the plow on, etc. But we made it. It's the morning. So now today I'm headed out for breakfast, and then right after breakfast I'm heading to the studio. Okay, I'll show you that in a second. We are, sorry, I have like stuff all over because we had the performance last night, but we are having today a dance awards day at the studio, and everyone who is age 3 and up who chose to do exams in November, we got all of their awards from Scotland in the mail and their certificates and everything. And when we were doing the tests in November, I just thought the dance stars were so cute and they were so proud of themselves, and when they were walking out they were so excited that they did an exam. So I was like, okay, I feel like we just really have to foster, like, they should be so excited that they did this. And we had some parents say, like, some things that really stuck with me, that there was one dancer who went in and her mom was like, she's never even like entered a room without her or the dancer's dad. And she went into the room and she did her little exam all on her own. So I was like, oh my gosh, they just have to be so proud of themselves. So I wanted to make the dance awards a big deal, and it is a big deal. Like, they're just 3 for some of them, and they did so great on their little tests. So we're doing Dance Awards Day. It ended up being, we put out an RSVP and we're just hosting it at the studio, and then 71 people responded, and we were like, okay, we can't fit 71 people in the studio at one time. So we split it into 2 groups. Still gonna be a full studio, but everyone's families are coming. So giving me ideas for next year also, but so that should be really cute. And we got some really cute stuff for them. One, I had to get a red carpet because I was like, I need them to walk down a red carpet to get these little awards. So we'll get this set up. I got these streamers. They're like gold. Either I'm gonna hang them across the door when they come in, or on the window. We'll see what the vibes are like. And then this is so cute. I bought these little stars and I'm gonna put their names on it, and it's gonna be like a little hall of fame. So they can take a picture. And then when we do the awards, we're gonna present them. We have kind of like a photo station for them. So I had to curl my hair this morning because I was like, okay, people are probably, I'm gonna be presenting the awards and probably taking a lot of pictures with dancers with our mural, and then we'll have a photo station. They can take pictures with their dance friends or their family and also get some individual shots. And then one of our best dance parents ever, Laura, she made cupcakes for all of them. We were supposed to have asked her several weeks ago, and then it just kind of slipped through the cracks. So we ended up asking her this week, and then she was like, almost said she couldn't do it. And then she was like, no, I'm gonna do it. I will show you these cupcakes later. They are like above and beyond. She is the greatest. So we also have cupcakes for them to celebrate with. It's gonna be a great day. And then today is also the Kilted Skate. I can't even skate. Embarrassing for a Canadian. But so I'm not going to the Kilted Skate, but a lot of the dancers, we moved the dance awards so that they could go to the awards and then head to the Kilted Skate. So it's honestly just a really cute day. Okay, breakfast over. Delicious for people who live in Fredericton. Coffee mill never misses. At the studio now, and I'm going to show you, I forgot, and I also have to take a picture of these, but we got new studio signs. So I'm gonna show you what it looks like. Yeah.
This is so freaking cute.
My sister has a hair salon two doors down from the studio.
Did you see our new signs?
Yes, and everybody, all of my clients are commenting on it.
Okay, slay! That's what I mean. Okay, here is our end result of our Hall of Fame. Okay, dance awards done. That was the cutest freaking thing I've ever done in my whole life. The little dance stars were so cute. And we have some footage from an iPhone for them like walking the red carpet. So hopefully you'll have already watched it if you're watching this point, if I can fit it in. But if not, anyway, I'll have it on our Instagram. So cute. It was so cute to see all the families like cheering for the little dancers. And they were so excited to get their little medals and awards. So anyway, that was fab. Now I'm at the Kilted Skate. I'm not skating, but a lot of my dancers are here. So I thought I would go say hey, see what everyone's up to. And I will take you along. I hope that there's lots of people at the rink in their kilts. So let's go check it out. Ready? You're gonna show me a trick? Woo! That's good. Cute. How's it going? Here, show me a trick, Charlotte. Yeah, I need a trick.
Show her the thing you were talking about. Right?
Oh my God. Woo! Kilt skate, so cute. I'm feeling very inspired to learn how to skate now. Like, I immediately want to go buy skates. I'm gonna think that one over. But we were just saying we should all go as a studio together, just like separate. We can wear kilts and skate whenever we want. Anyway, so left the gals there. They're having lots of fun. People took some tumbles. It was good. And now I don't have anything else dance related scheduled for the rest of the day. I'm gonna go chill. And then another full day tomorrow. I'm gonna meet with Kate. She does a lot of the studio management stuff with me, so we're just gonna have a meeting / brainstorming / recital planning tomorrow. And then I have Shanachie Dance Company. So it's a full weekend, but it just feels very wholesome today. So it really gave me a lot of good vibes. Thank you.
two to-go snacks because actual hanger.
Ignore my literal dungeon office at the studio. Just hung out at Tipsy Muse just from literally 11 a.m. until 3:30 p.m. doing some planning things with Kate. We had like a trip to talk about and then recital. And then there was some stuff we didn't get to. Now I am at the studio about to get changed. Shanachie Senior, Shanachie Junior practices today. Then home, quick call with someone for For Real Apparel. And then professional development session lecture from ScotDance Canada. And then that's my dance weekend over. I'm feeling like I wish I got a second coffee at the cafe. But we'll make it through. Okay, I also just have to share, since this was in the background, this is our old studio sign, which is now just rotting in the office. Because I was like, oh, well, like, what if I want to use it? And so we kept it. I don't know what I'll use it for, but it also has, like, I got the border replaced to a silver instead of red. So we'll see if I ever do anything with that or not, but that is our old sign. New ones showed you early in the video, much brighter.
Your square was way too big, okay? You gotta make it easier for yourself, so don't come out as tall.
All right. Hey, sweet darling, let's go dance.
And that is officially the end of my crazy dance-filled weekend. My weekends certainly don't always look like that, but this was just the perfect storm of all the dance activities, performances, dance studio things, professional development things. Just a very, honestly, fulfilling dance-filled weekend. So I hope you enjoyed coming along. This is definitely what my life looks like. Not all the time, but most of the time there's lots of dance stuff on the go, so I hope you enjoyed coming along. I'm starting my vlogging era, hopefully, so be sure to like, subscribe. Also going to hopefully be taking everyone along for the journey a lot more often, so I'll see you next time.